Doesn't this look amazing? Hi, I'm Joe, and today I'm going to learn you how to make a 3D GIS web model like this yourself. So let's get started. As you can see here, I created a QGIS project and I created a new shapefile called windmills and I imported a Google satellite image. The location I choose is the island of Madeira in the middle of the Atlantic Ocean. It's called Flower Island, and I've been there with my wife for 3 years to Flower Island. And as you can see, I placed points roughly on the location of existing windmills. And what I'm going to do now with them is I'm going to export them as a comma separated value file. So let's give the name. I already made a file called windmills. So yes, I want to place it here. Choose your coordinate reference system. Well, I chose the most common one, WGS84. And the only thing you have to take a look at is that you set geometry at SXY. And you can hit OK. In my case, it will ask if I will override, if I want to override the file, and I press OK. I want to do that. And what we're going to do now is to open our browser. In my case, it's Google Chrome, and it's opening in the wrong tree. And we're going to ArcGIS Online. And you might be thinking, ArcGIS is an S3 product. Isn't that commercial? Isn't that expensive? Yes, it is. But they also have something which is called a free online account. And that's what we're going to use today. So I'm sorry it's in Dutch, apparently. But you can click above here, which says sign on. And if you already have an open free account, you can just enter your credentials here. But if you don't have one, you can click here. Sorry again in Dutch. If you don't have an account, make an account. And you can click it there. Well, for the sole purpose of this course, I already created an account. So we're going to use that one. And I say sign on. As you can see, we are here at the S3 homepage of your own environment. And we're going to navigate to content because we're going to upload our comma separated value file. We can do that by click on new item and drag and drop your file or choose an option. Well, we're going to our own device. And we're going to pick the comma separated value file. Would I like to add some text to make it more searchable? Sure, we call it Madeira. And let's call it windmills. All right, next. What we now have, we uploaded the comma separated value file on the ArcGIS Online environment. And what we need to do is we need to share it with the whole world. As you can see now, we share it only with the owner, but we're going to share it with the entire world, with everyone, we make it public. Click save. And as you can see here, we got now a URL and we can copy that one because we need it. We need that URL to connect this data set with our 3D environment. So what we're going to do now is we click on scene, and scene is like S3 language for their 3D environment. And as you can see here, we start with the globe. Nope, we don't want to do anything with this. We just want to open. And as you can see the entire globe, which is round. But what we want to do is we want to have a flat surface. So we create a new local scene. All right, it's getting started. And let's go to Madeira. Yes, that's Madeira. And I choose this little hilltop, mountaintop. Let's call it a mountaintop. As you can see, it's already represented in 3D. We're going to change the base map to imagery. So it looks a little bit more realistic. And what we're going to do now, we're going to add a layer. What we're going to add is our comma separated value layer. Well, we paste the URL that we just created and we will call it windmills. and click on the Add button. Well, now the new layer is created. As you can see, we have little orange dots here on the location of the windmills. And I want to create really 3D windmills. Luckily, Esri has a default option to create 3D objects and to create a 3D windmill. So click on Option. And we're going to change the marker from a basic shape to the default windmill wind turbine structure. Okay, let's do it. As you can see, they are really, really small. I looked it up and these windmills are around 99 meters. So we choose that. And now they look really a lot better. So we press done and done again. And there we have it. We have our own windmill farm on this mountaintop. We can even choose to, well, do something with the daylight. Add shadow, for instance. Play a little bit with the shadow. And all we're going to do now, we're going to save it. And we're going to call it a windmill farm. I don't want any text or something. And we're going to press save. Well, it's saved. And what we're now going to do, we're going to create an app. And we choose here, Instant App. And there's one nice option, which is create a 3D viewer, this one, and we choose that one. Yeah, give your app a title, Windmill Farm Web App. All right, create app. Always nice that this is another font than the entirety of the other website. All right, it's almost finished loading. And as you can see here, we have our little windmill farm on the top of this mountain in Madeira. I can still move it around. And what we're going to do, we're going to follow this wizard. And we start with the first step. That one, would we like to use this scene? Yes. Next one, would you like to add something to express it a little bit more? Like a legend? Well, because we only have the windmills and the legend, that's not really useful, but we'll keep it on. But we want to maybe add a header. All right, looking nice. Next, how would you like to add even more? Well, social sharing, so we can share it with other people. All right, next, and select the mode. Well, it's probably light or dark mode. Well, I keep it like a light mode. Select the present theme. Well, I like the forest theme. Ah, look quite nice. All we can do here is we can arrange the buttons of the web application. And we're going to put everything in the top left corner. So everything is now here. And we click publish. And hit confirm. Well, we've done that. What it says now is that we are still sharing it as a owner and not to the entirety of the world. So what we're going to do, we're going to change the share settings by clicking on them and put it on everybody. Strange that the entire website is in English, and when I push this button, it's going to be Dutch, but never mind. I click save. As you can see here, it's also in Dutch, so I will translate for you. It says some items, our web scene, is not visible for others because it's shared differently. Would we like to update this so it's also shared with the entirety of the world? And we click on actualize. It's being updated. Cool. Well, now everything is updated. Yeah, sure. Publish again. One more time. All right, now everything is changed. As you can see, it's now on sharing level public, and we do copy link. All right, and I will open an incognito browser. And if everything is all right, we will now see our 3D web GIS model. which we make for free, and we can share with everybody in the world. And it is looking really nice, guys. I really like it. The reason why this piece of Esri software is free is to encourage people to create more content, and you have the option to keep everything for yourself or to share it with the entirety of the world. And by sharing it with the entirety of the world, you generate content which they can use in their living atlas, which is an atlas of all data sets that users on the Esri platform can use. So I think that sums it up. I hope you enjoyed watching this video and you learned something. If you did, please hit the like button and even consider subscribing. It really mean a lot to me. Well, thank you for watching, and until next time, goodbye.